Hello, Bowleggers, and welcome back. I'm back in the kitchen again. Today we're going to do something. We're going to do some fried cauliflower. I've had it at several different restaurants, and I'm sure you guys have had it too. And I've cooked it at home a couple of times, but not too often. But I came across a good deal on some cauliflowers the other day, so I figured, you know what, I don't particularly care for cooked, boiled cauliflower, even though it's very healthy for you and you have some very good nutrients in it. But I myself, you know, the old fry guy, I got to have my fried food, so I prefer it fried. So I'm going to fry some cauliflower florets. And what I've done, I've taken the florets, the cauliflower, and I've cut them up into little florets like such. And we're going to take them and we're going to bathe them in a bath. That's a mixture of buttermilk, two eggs, and a fourth cup of water. And I've added black pepper, two teaspoons of black pepper, a teaspoon of garlic salt, and a teaspoon of pepper. Now, in the flour mixture, what I've done, I have 2 cups of flour here, and I've added 1 teaspoon of black pepper and 1 teaspoon of cumin. And now we're going to go ahead and start getting these dredged up and get them ready to go in our grease. We got our grease over here. This should be right around 375 degrees. It should be about ready. It's been simmering there a good 10 minutes now. But let's go ahead and again get our florets done. And what we're going to do, we're going to take a floret at a time, put it into our egg bath. Then we want to take it and flour it in our flour bath here. Then you want to take it back, get it coated very good with the flour. You want to take it back to the egg wash, the buttermilk and egg wash. And then back into the flour once again for the last time. In other words, you're going to have you're going to do it twice. It's going to have 2 coatings of the egg wash, and it's going to have 2 coatings of the flour. And we're going to set this aside. Go on to our next one. We're going to soak that good. Go to our flour. Back to the egg bath. And back to the last flour. And you're going to repeat this step with each floret. Depends on however many florets you're cooking. I got quite a few here. I'm not sure if I'm going to cook all of them, but fry all of them. What I may do is steam some of them and have them for lunch tomorrow. But this is these are the steps that you're going to take. You're going to continue to flour and dip them into the egg and buttermilk bath. Now, I tell you guys what, I'm going to go ahead and finish doing these and finish flouring up my florets here. And I will bring you back in a moment when I'm finished with all of them. So I'll see you in a few. All right, guys, welcome back. We're going to go ahead now. As you can see, I got all my florets floured, and we're going to go ahead and drop them into our hot oil, which is about 375 degrees. And you want to let them fry until they get a light golden brown. Be careful when you put them in. You don't want to splash that hot grease on you. There we go. And we're going to let them cook probably about a good 10 to 12 minutes. And when you do this, it's always best to deep fry them. I've never heard of you frying them like in a frying pan. It's always best to have like a Dutch oven or a Fry Daddy where you can deep fry them. It always works best. Uh, Okay. They're looking good. They're beginning to float to the top. But now when they float to the top, that don't mean that they're done. That means that that flour is beginning to cook and they're getting a little lighter. The reason they're floating to the top. But just continue to allow them to stay in and get a little more golden brown. Because like I said, the process is going to take, they're going to fry anywhere from a good 10 to 12 minutes. But that's what they look like frying. Tell you what, we're going to turn that stove up a little bit. Well, I'm going to go ahead and finish battering up my other ones and get those ready to go in the grease. And I'll bring you guys back in a few and show you the finished product of all of them. Well, guys, this first batch is done. And let me show you what they look like. It took about a good, I'll say about 11 minutes. They've been frying. And there we go. Those are fried cauliflower. And I'm sure they taste just as great as they smell. And you can pretty much, it's the same method pretty much if you're doing like fried mushrooms, fried green tomatoes, and such. It's pretty much the same method. The cauliflower takes a little longer though due to the fact the cauliflower is a little thicker. So it's gonna have to fry a little bit longer. Alrighty. And that's it. That is our fried cauliflower. I hope you guys try this recipe. And if you give it a shot, don't forget to hit me in my email and let me know what you think. Remember, my email is at rickyj429@gmail.com, and I can be reached pretty much any time, day or night, at that email. But give me a holler and let me know what you think of the fried cauliflower. But definitely give it a shot. You guys have a blessed day, and remember, always try and be someone's blessing. Have a good one. Bye-bye.